coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Man, there is a lot of news today. Unbelievable amounts of it. And as usual, I'll try to babble through most of it. David Knight and Joe Biggs are in Virginia right now. And we are going to have a live report from them on the ground. Remember back in February, we reported on the giant fake city built in the wooded hills of Virginia, where they are basically training to occupy U.S. cities. Well, we have put in scores of phone calls and emails and requests to be given an interview and to be able to look at the base and go in and get a basic citizen inspection of it. It's got models of what look like Baptist churches, you name it. The street signs are marked for the U.S., marked D.C. subway. And we know it's all part of the giant urban warfare training program and overall PSYOP to condition the public. But they have not responded to us and have ignored us and refused our request, haven't even talked to us. You know, because we have millions of listeners and millions of viewers and 400 million views on one YouTube channel. We don't exist. We're just U.S. citizens, and, well, they're training the U.S. military in there for treason. The Army Times, Stars and Stripes all pushed the idea of brigade homeland and troops on the streets, something that was denied for 15-plus years when I was exposing it, but the last 5 or 6 years has been admitted. So we're going to go to a live report with them outside the base coming up in the next segment, and then they're going to try to go on the base and talk to the colonel, who we've been in contact with and who will not give us a response about our request for an interview to be able to find out exactly what's going on. Now, it's a military base inside of a military base, and Staff Sergeant Joe Biggs, who's now a full-time InfoWars reporter and moved down here from North Carolina, he's a famous soldier. They had a big Esquire article about him 3 or 4 years ago when he was in Afghanistan and Iraq, and they had embedded reporters, Michael Hastings, inside some of the heaviest battles that they've seen in recent times in those areas, especially Afghanistan. And then, of course, he helped expose the clear evidence that looks like Hastings was murdered. So that's the kind of reporter we want. He's down there as well to communicate in the Army parlance there at the training center, where they admit they're merging the FBI, the local police, everyone into this giant FEMA center. And they, a lot of times, double these training centers as emergency relocation centers. And from what Biggs has seen, it does look like it's set up to be basically a giant FEMA camp. It's got the sports stadiums, the whole nine yards, and it is to train the troops to basically storm and occupy and hold U.S. cities, take control of communications, you name it. And you're seeing army.mil footage that they shot. They haven't let any other media on the base. They did talk to one reporter and allow him to do an interview. That reporter was scared to talk to us in person, but said he would talk to David Knight over the phone. So that interview, I'm told, was to be conducted about an hour ago. I haven't talked to our reporters yet. We're connecting them right now. So we'll spend some time on that live as this unfolds, coming up in the next segment with our live audio video feeds. The headline, if you want to refresh yourself with the original article from February, is U.S. Army builds fake city in Virginia to practice military occupation of the U.S. Martial law training, 300-acre town, includes sports stadium, school, churches, underground subway, you name it. So I said we'd send reporters out there, and after, I don't know, 4 months of stonewalling, or I guess about 3-4 months of stonewalling, we have sent our reporters to Virginia. And so we're going to be talking to them. Now, obviously, the big news, and I meant to cover this yesterday. I'm glad DrudgeReport.com reminded me, because there's all the links. It's developed more, that Obama's releasing hundreds of thousands of violent illegals, 30-plus thousand of them aggravated felons. We're talking rape, we're talking armed assault, we're talking armed robbery. And Lamar Smith, the congressman, has called it a government-sanctioned prison break, and that's what it is. 15th day of May 2014. We are going to be going live to outside Bowling Green, Virginia, at a U.S. Army base that within it has a training camp with mock churches, public schools, and a D.C. subway. The military admittedly has been training to take on the Tea Party and American gun owners. That's even in Foreign Affairs publication. That's in the Washington Post, Forbes, the Washington Times. We broke all that information, but now it's confirmed. And the reason the military is waking up right now is that they're being trained to carry this out. Now, certainly this base has dual usage, and but the military has been so trained that reporters are bad that we're going to see what happens when our reporters, who are a few minutes outside the base, I'm going to give you the name of the base and all the details, try to go in and talk to the public information officer and the colonel that we've been talking to for 3+ months since February, who refused to answer any questions or give us an interview. We've been stonewalled, so we've sent our reporters there. The headline, U.S. Army builds fake city to shoot at during training. That's the London Telegraph. We gave a deep analysis of it. U.S. Army builds fake city in Virginia to practice military occupation of America. So that is coming up in a moment. Then, huge Second Amendment news on multiple fronts. Court upholds warrantless entry, seizure of gun rights. That's in Florida. In Illinois, Second Amendment, clear and present danger. That's a quote. We're going to be breaking that down. Talking about clear and present danger, hundreds of thousands of illegals that are felons have been released in the last 6 years under Obama. Just released. Now 36,000 aggravated felons, or people awaiting trial or deportation for aggravated crimes, were just released on the streets. Now, again, they got to grope your sons and your daughters and your wife and your husband to make sure they're not Al-Qaeda, even though the government openly funds Al-Qaeda publicly. But they will release 36,000 felons and criminals in just one release this week. And now people are telling it like it is. Congressman Lamar Smith of South Texas has come out and said that the release is the equivalent of criminal immigrants, a government-sanctioned prison break. That's the headline. Lamar Smith calls ICE release of 36,000 criminal immigrants a presidentially sanctioned prison break. Yes, that's what it is. Here's another one. Feds release hundreds of immigrant murderers, drunk drivers, sex crime convicts. We're talking child rapists, folks. Release of 36,000 criminal illegals, impeachable offense, ask WorldNet Daily. I don't know, is Jeffrey Dahmer, should he be in prison? I mean, this is the type of total criminal activity that's going on. By fiat, they've more than tripled the amount of people not even getting a hearing on deportation. They just release you. We're talking about above the law. And criminals from Mexico, the drug dealers, the cartels, are just running rampant. 193 people with homicide convictions were just released. 426 sexual assault convictions released. This is just in one group. 303 kidnapping convictions. 303 kidnappers. 1,075 aggravated assault convictions. That means with a weapon. 1,160 stolen vehicle convictions. 9,187 dangerous drug convictions, 16,070 drunk or drug driving convictions, 303 flight escape convictions. The government is lawless, ladies and gentlemen. Meanwhile, the military, the Army, the Marines, they're not training to take on criminals overflowing our borders, which is constitutional. They could, the military could be there. No. They're there trying to introduce drugs and things that aren't, you know, being laundered to the right banks. They're busy in the Army Times, in Stars and Stripes. Oh, this is all public under NORTHCOM training to take on returning veterans, number one, gun owners, libertarians, constitutionalists, and even mainline conservatives and Christians. Remember, even Fox News a few months ago had the headline, Army soldiers told at Fort Hood they can't be part of evangelical church or the Tea Party, they may be court-martialed. That's like saying, You'll be court-martialed if we find out you're part of the PTA or something. You're part of a Rotary Club. Does Army consider Christian Tea Party a terror threat? Fox News. Then you read the article. It says you will be court-martialed. Folks, this is the chilling effect where they are indicting and going after pro-life groups. They are arresting filmmakers. They are arresting governors for crooked toenails that are Republicans. The Democrats are involved in a takeover right now. And again, I'm not glorifying the Republicans. They have been part of it. But the Democrats are making a power move right now to take this country over. And once they've done that, they're going to screw the average Democratic voter as well. Look what Obamacare does. And I'm not saying the Republicans are going to save us either, but the Republican and Democratic leadership are all targeting. They're all targeting any opposition to this globalist takeover. And the Republican leadership is going after the Tea Party as well. I know I harp on that. So that's all coming up today as well. Huge Russia news, huge NSA news. I'm going to cover it all. Huge fear-mongering that if we don't